The Earth from heaven's perspective. How does our Earth look from heaven's view? We know that it's round and that there are many houses and countries, but what does it look like from heaven's view? It was very exciting, the Lord said, "Behold," and heaven opened up and I could see the whole Earth, but not as a globe, and not as a map in a geographical project, but as flat ground, although I was aware at the same time that the Earth was round, yet I could see every point on the Earth very clearly. I saw the bottom of the ocean and every house, and the roofs of the houses were as if they were not there at all. At the same moment, I was able to see the whole Earth, and I could also see all of the people in one scenario. I saw people in their homes, as they slept, and also those who were awake and were walking around in them, and in other places, they were working. Every thought of each person was recorded, either by an angel or by a demon that followed that person. Every thought was visible and was shining. In this way, either an angel or a demon recorded it. When they were awake, I was astonished by their faces. I saw so many ugly faces, do you understand? Unbelievably terrible faces, I could say, beastly. I asked, Lord, why are there so many ugly faces? I was on the earth, not so long ago, and I saw very lovely faces. The Lord answered, you saw the masks which they put on, you saw them according to the flesh, but now you see them as they truly are. Tell people that this time is coming to its end. I am standing at the door, repent. I also saw people as they were sleeping and who it is who gives them their dreams. I saw them as they were going to sleep, and how they had something which they were thinking about before they went to bed, and according to these thoughts, either an angel would give them a dream in which he brought a solution to a problem they had, or a demon is bringing them terror and nightmares. I saw as the demons would take on themselves the appearance of a human and would come into their dream. I asked the Lord why they were doing this. Why were they taking on a human appearance? This was happening mainly to those who have lost close relatives and would not let them go from their life. The demons were taking advantage of them, so that they would give counsel to those alive, in the appearance of a human. Paul says in the Epistle of Ephesians 4:26-27, be angry, and sin not, let not the sun go down upon your wrath, neither give place to the devil. Look at that connection. If we are going to sleep and we give place to the devil, he will surely take that place, in the form of thoughts or grief. That's why the word says to forgive before the sun goes down. Why is the Lord telling us not to go to sleep with these burdens? It's not just by chance. Don't give the devil a place. And to people who think that they already are Christians, you can give him a place as well. If you are a Christian, then respect God's word. Don't go to sleep with anger, offended. Before you go to sleep, give it up to God, and in your repentance, the devil will not have any place. God will protect you at night, and in your sleep, he will teach you. Then I suddenly saw not only all of the people and all the houses, but I also saw churches. On some of the church bells, I saw demons. As they tried to ring them, they would jump off of those bells on the shoulders of people and would tell them ugly things, and people would say, have you heard about this? And they would begin to share the thoughts from the demons all around them, and in this same way, they would also come into the churches, and in those churches, I saw the demons bringing fire from hell for people to become religious. People would light the candles and they would be thinking about what icon to put by that candle, and another demon would grab the person and would lead the person to which icon to give this candle. Then the demon himself would jump behind this icon and would represent himself there. Interviewer, that fire belongs to him, but is it that way in every church? No, I saw various churches. Churches are all different. I saw the Orthodox Cathedral, and people with a respect would come in there. They would read God's word in there, and those demons could not come closer because of that. They even had to jump off of those people that were carrying them. Interviewer, at the entrance, isn't that right? Yes, at the entrance, they had to jump off. They could not enter there. I said, Lord, our evangelical churches are surely also this pure. And then I saw my church. I saw from there in heaven as my sisters and brothers were going to a meeting. I also saw myself, edgy and sleepy, because I had worked a night shift, and I was dragging my children there, and I saw how, in this irritated state, a demon would cling to me, I saw him jump and tweak my children, and my younger son started to run wild. It made me even more irritated, so I grabbed them and put them into the first row. I would then raise a warning finger to tell them that God sees everything, God sees everything. And I myself would go and sit in the back pew. I saw how the meeting started, and I saw how my children were sitting there, with their hands on their knees, watching the servant preacher and quietly hating God. When I saw this, I felt terrible, I felt horrible, but I understood that this was the reason why every one of my children had given me a bitter cup to drink. In one of those levels of hell, there were people who were causing division, division in everything, in their family, in their church, and among people. We were descending from one level to another level. When we were descending into these levels, I saw familiar faces of people that had already passed into eternity. I had previously thought that these people were saved and that they had gone to heaven, but in reality, some of them had ended up in hell. I saw demons and they resembled hammersmiths. They had leather aprons on, axes in their hands, and they were splitting those souls there. They would cut them in half, and I could see, as every part of that separated body was wriggling from pain, and they cut them into even smaller pieces and then even smaller. And when I thought this torture was finished, then all the parts came back together and that soul was made whole again, and the torture would start over again. When they cut their bodies, there was no blood anywhere. There was pain, but not blood. I asked, "Why is there no blood?" And the angel answered, "The blood belongs to the Lord." I remembered that, yes, I have been redeemed by the blood. And then again, I saw a well-known face being tortured and I shouted, "Why? Why do they have to suffer like this?" And the angel said, "These are those who are causing divisions while on earth." I did not understand. "What division? What are you talking about?" He said, "They were dividing families. They caused divisions at their workplace, and they brought division to the body of Christ in the church and everywhere they went. They served only themselves and cared only for themselves, and now they feel division in its full range. Now they are being divided." Again, I lifted up my eyes to heaven and began to praise the Lord for protecting me while I was on the earth. There was not even a thought about any division in my mind. This meant that I will never get inside of that level. Hallelujah. We are at the sixth level of hell. That's the place where the occultist and psychics and those predicting the future by astrology are, and those demons are touching them on those parts of the body with which they were sinning. And so, if they were predicting the future by the cards, demons came to them and were giving them hot burning cards right into their hands, and it tormented them by burning them. And if the person was predicting the future by looking into a coffee cup and what was left on the bottom, then it is being thrown into his eyes and they are telling them, "You saw, you looked." Gal 6:7, "Be not deceived, God is not mocked, for whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap." In the level of hell, where the lake of fire is located, it is empty for now. Even though Satan tries to throw the souls of people in there, we descended into the lowest part of hell, to the ninth level. It is a horrible, terrible part because I found myself among the group of people. Some were taller, some shorter, and they were all covered with scarves. There were all kinds of people: prostitutes, homosexuals, people who were doing things there that would be better not even to mention. It was a terrible place. People who were there had their faces somehow fused into each other, because they have reaped what they have sown. As homosexuals and lesbians, their faces are mingled into one another, and they looked like, I don't want to say their faces looked like animals because it would be an offense to the animals. They looked like monsters, disgusting, disharmonious, hybrid animals, but much worse looking, and their eyes were full of hatred and evil. And there, I heard loud music. The music that was playing there was heavy metal. Interviewer: "So that kind of heavy metal music has been created to take over people." Friends: "Please do not listen to heavy metal music. People often ask me about it, and they say that it's just another kind of music, and you can glorify God by heavy metal." Yes, glorify, but not God. "You will glorify the Prince of Darkness." Interviewer: "What kind of industry did you see there, and what did you see after that happening on the earth?" The first thing that caught my attention was how the new clothing fashions were being fashioned in hell. I saw how they were being made. In one piece of clothing that the demons were carrying to the earth, I recognized the shirt of my son. I was simply astounded. I remembered how our pastor had once told me, "Sister, do you notice how your son is dressing? Part of his naked body is being shown through his clothes." I had answered him, "Oh, come on, pastor, it's just young people, you know, they will change after they figure it out." But I did not realize that this clothing was being fashioned in hell. I thought, "In hell, and what for?" God showed me, as I saw an innocent sister stealing a look at his naked chest showing off through that shirt on my son. Then, she was saddened and did not pay attention to the sermon being preached anymore. The enemy had come to her and she was being tempted, and my son did not even know that the temptation had come because of him. But the Bible clearly says, "Woe unto those through whom the temptations come," Luke 7:1. And he said unto his disciples, "It is impossible but that occasions of stumbling should come, but woe unto him, through whom they come." I saw food. They were making all kinds of recipes, for instance, how to make the poppy, how it will be absorbed, and poppy leaves also, and how to make different opium drinks, etc., from them. And I heard among the young people many times how great they felt after being in that restaurant. I also saw printed shirts with different things printed on them according to what each person liked, and the shirt is the demonstration of oneself. I also saw children's shirts being made with Pokemon printed on them. Interviewer, who knows what a Pokemon is? It's actually a painted demon, from the message on YouTube by ex-satanic high priest exposing the symbols, Stephen Dollins. A lightning is a symbol of Satan in Satanism. Jesus said in Luke 10:18, "I beheld Satan fallen as lightning from heaven." The Satanists took it as a symbol of Satan from the Bible. The double SS or Z is used in the occult world and it represents a spirit of destiny. It was also taken by Hitler, who was in the occult and a follower of Satanist named Aleister Crowley. In Satanism, the double SS means a king in Satan's service. All the cartoon figures represent different occult powers and secret satanic powers, and the children are taught to believe that by collecting the pictures of these figures, they will possess special powers. Stephen Dollins talks about a child who was playing with his cards during a class who attacked his teacher because she took his Pokemon cards away from him. The boy said that she was stealing his powers. Hundreds of children in Japan had to be hospitalized when the Pokemon movie was first released in Japan because they had epileptic seizure attacks while watching, even though none of them had ever had one before. Stephen Dollins says it's a real demonic attack on them because of the satanic message of symbolism in this evil, selfish cartoon character, which appears innocent outwardly. It's horrible. There were pencils, pens, and t-shirts with pictures of all kinds of these characters and also secret writings. One of the writings was formed so secretly that if you have taken those letters and put them down together on the line, they said that Jesus, "And now, please forgive for saying this, is a swine." That's how it was. With terror, I watched as they took that t-shirt and gave it to my son, and he was wearing it. At first glance, the letters just looked like scattered letters, but there were actually small arrows pointing the way to tag together with the letters. In the middle of that t-shirt, on the chest, there was a small icon of a swine. It was such a great shock for me. I had never paid attention to those letters before. Parts of them were also written in Latin, and we, in our ignorance, are buying those things for our children. Interviewer, we were talking about one soul who was being brought into the throne room of the devil, and it was commanded, "Bind that soul. He has sold himself out." There, souls are being dedicated to Satan. Now, I'm not only talking about Christians but about people who do not obey Christ and have sold out their own souls for glory and power. As Tatiana saw the soul being bound and a demon comes to reign instead of that soul, as an example, from history, we can look at Hitler. How many of you know that before he made a covenant with Satan and sold out his soul, he was just an ordinary man, no different from anyone else? After the covenant, everybody was afraid of him. Why? An exchange had happened, and this animalistic change is known throughout the world. Interviewer, all right, now you are returning back, what did you feel? I grabbed hold of the angel and I was saying, "Come, let us go," and suddenly, there came a voice, and even hell was shaken underneath from the sound of that voice, and, in fear, all of those demons began to hide one behind the other. They literally started to swallow each other, just to be able to hide, and the voice was God's voice and he said, "Enough, she has to go," and, we were suddenly standing at that curtain made out of a cloud again. Then, we went through it, and the Lord said, "Return and tell the people all that you have seen, and tell them, the time has drawn nigh, repent." I took a deep breath and that breath made me alive. The angel gently touched my shoulder and said, "It's time," and I started to fly back down there. When I was leaving this earth I was going with joy and freedom, but when I was flying back down here, I was going faster and it was very painful. Then slowly, I started to feel the pain again. The pain began to increase more and more, and when this pain reached its maximum, I screamed out, but I was ashamed. I had been in hell only a short time ago, and in comparing the pain here with the pain that people experience in hell, it's like getting bit by a mosquito, which is not even a pain. I said, "Lord, I accept this pain, just don't send me to see hell anymore, not even for a short trip, that's a terrible place." Then, it was quiet, but, I realized that I heard someone else screaming. I tried to sit down, I was lying on something cold and hard. I sat down, but I could not see, as if my eyelids were closed. I touched my forehead with my hand and I realized that my loose skin was falling down over my eyes, as they had not stitched up the opening in my head. I pulled it back like this, so I could see, and, I saw the room and the tiled wall. Then, I saw a woman wearing a white cloak, sitting in some water. The bucket had been thrown down and the water had spilled out all over the floor, and in her hands, she was holding a mop. She was looking at me very pathetically now. She was not only screaming, but she was also groaning as well, "Ahawah," while pointing at me. So, with my hand holding my skin at my forehead I asked her, "Why are you screaming?" Well, it would have been better if I had not said a word at that moment, because that poor woman's face turned as white as a sheet. So, I said to her, "Don't be afraid, don't scream." Then, she flipped over and on all fours, with her hands and feet, she quickly made her way to the door and went out. Then, the door shut. I started to think about what was happening, after the heat in hell. Now I started to feel cold. I looked at myself and saw that I was naked. The sheet that had been covering me had fallen to one side. I saw that on one of my thighs, there were some numbers written in green ink, and on the other thigh, my name and surname. I understood that it was the information about my death and a number that indicated my sickness. That's how they label dead bodies. I had spent time in an autopsy room before, as a doctor, when I had to take my exams for anatomy and surgery. Excerpts from Tatiana Bellis Raised from the Dead After 72 Hours. This PDF was created from screenshots taken of the book in its original form. You may read the book in its original form here. This three-part testimony is the core of the book, but the rest of the book is equally riveting and edifying too. Tatiana Bellis, of Odessa, Ukraine.